Yo, what's up guys, it's Blixty, and today I'm going to be going through a tutorial how to use your Strikepack on your PC in 2023. Now I know there was an old method of using SCP toolkit and using its drivers to format your PS4 controller into Xbox, but as of 2023 that method has been patched as the drivers aren't supported by Windows anymore. So today I'm going to be showing you guys how to use an alternate method of using your Strikepack on your computer. So you want to attach your PS4 controller and the Strikepack together, but do not plug it into your PC yet. Before we go into the first step, make sure you guys have an unzipping tool or an extractor such as 7-Zip or WinRAR. If not, I'll be using WinRAR, so I'll leave a link to that download in the description. And once you have that downloaded, you could go ahead to Chrome, and then you want to type game pad viewer and click on this website. Now with your Strikepack attached to your PS4 controller, you can now go ahead and connect your PS4 controller to your computer using the Strikepack wire, and then boom. There's no way to show you guys this, but on my PS4 controller there's currently no light on. If you heard the noise, the doo-doo-doo noise on your computer, that means it's connected. Even though there's no light on your controller, don't freak out. Once you're at this web page, go over to player one and press some buttons on your controller. If you are getting feedback like I am on all of your buttons, some buttons may be a little incorrect, but we're gonna get that all sorted. Just make sure that you're getting some sort of feedback. And once you are, you can head over to the second link in the description. This one is x360ce. It'll be this controller emulator website. You want to head on over to it, and at the top of the page, click download for all games. Now I already have it downloaded, but for video purposes, I'll go ahead and download it again. Once it's done, open it and just let it load. And once you have done that, it should come up as so. Okay, there we go. Your application should look somewhat like this, if not exactly similar. So you want to make sure in this game tab, you want to make sure that it is set to X360 controller emulator. And once it is, make sure you're on the controller one page or tab of this app. And you want to click this green add button. This adds your controller to the application. And then I'll walk you guys through it with the further steps. So like I said, I'm on a PS4 controller, DualShock 4. So this is being read by Sony Interactive Entertainment Wireless Controller. Obviously, PS4. Click Add Selected Device. And then boom, your application should look like this. This means that your controller is being read by this application. So all you're doing now is remapping all your buttons to whatever it corresponds with. For example, on my PS4 controller, I'm going to pick it up. I'll start with my triggers. You'll click this right trigger and hit R2. And as you see, every time I hit my trigger, I'm getting feedback. You can do the same for the left side. You want to click L2. And then for your right bumper, you want to go ahead and click R1. For the left side, you want to click L1. For Y, this will be triangle on the PS4 controller. For B, this would be circle on the PS4 controller. A would be cross on the PS4 controller. X, square. For the start button, this will be your options button. And then for back, this would be your touchpad button. So as you can see, my buttons are being read by this application. It's being highlighted in green. That means I'm touching them. So now let's move on to your joysticks. Now you want to be careful with this because any wrong movement can lead to it being, how do I say this? It won't be programmed, right? So you'll be putting let's say you move your joystick upwards, and then if you incorrectly bind it, it'll go down when you try to go up. So just make sure you're doing this very precisely so there's no errors. So you want to click upwards. You want to go over the joystick, click upwards, and then on your left joystick, you want to push it upwards. To the left, you want to move your joystick to the left, to the right, to the right, down, and move it down. And then And now we can head on over to our left, our L3 click. So that's pushing in your left joystick. Click the center of the joystick and then push it down. So as you see, I have full 360 movement on my joystick, and every time I press it L3, it's being highlighted in the center. Now the same thing goes for your right stick. You want to move it upwards or up, right, down, left. As you can see, I have full 360 movement on my joystick. Now for the R stick bind, you want to push it inwards as well. So now I have full 360 movement and I have my left stick and right stick buttons binded. So I'm gonna go ahead and do my D-pad now. This one is straightforward, up, upwards, up on the D-pad, right, right on the D-pad, down, down on the D-pad, and left, left on the D-pad. Now, this next step is optional. Your controller is fully functional. But if you guys want to lower your latency on these buttons, because this is an emulator, so there will be slight input delay. So if you want to lower it, you want to head over to the D-pad, to the D-pad tab, and click access to D-pad enabled and move your dead zone all the way down to zero. For your triggers, you could also do the same thing. Leave anti-dead zone at zero and move your dead zone zero so you see a red linear line on this graph. And do it for your other trigger as well. And when you're playing, you could go ahead and click save all. So once you open your PC and run this application, or if it starts as you start up your application, all your settings will be saved. So you go ahead and minimize it, stay in your tray. You can go ahead and do this. And now let's go into Fortnite. Let's see how it works. All right, guys, so here I am in Fortnite after doing the tweak in that application that I just ran. My controller is fully functional in game. I can pull out my map with touchpad. My right paddle is crouch. My left paddle is jump. You could also bind those to whatever you want to on your strike pack. But for me, that's what I use. But yeah, you can see that my controller is fully functional. There's almost no input delay from the application. It feels really smooth. I really can't complain. This feels, if not, a little bit smoother than the old method connecting the controller. But otherwise than that, this is a really good solution to use your controller after the driver isn't supported by Windows anymore. But yeah, that's pretty much it. If this video worked for you, leave a like and a comment saying it worked. And if not, you could leave a comment in the comment section below. I'll try to answer all any questions that I can. And yeah, if this liked, please like, subscribe, share this with a few other people as well. Because I know a lot of people with strike packs who have this problem and can't seem to get it to work. But otherwise than that, hope you guys have a good day or night, whatever time of the day you're watching. And I'm out. Peace.